Romans 16:25-27. Now to him who is able to establish you by my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery hidden for long ages past, but now revealed and made known to the prophetic writings by the command of the eternal God, so that all nations might believe and obey him. To the only wise God be glory forever to Jesus Christ. Amen. In Galatians 1:6-12, I am astonished that you are so quickly deserting the one who called you by the grace of Christ and are turning to a different gospel, which is really no gospel at all. Evidently, some people are throwing you into confusion and are trying to pervert the gospel of Christ. But even if we or an angel from heaven should preach a gospel other than the one we preach to you, let him be eternally condemned. As we have already said, so now I say again, if anybody is preaching to you a gospel other than what you accepted, let him be eternally condemned. And now, am I now trying to win the approval of men or of God? Or am I trying to please men? If I were still trying to please men, I will not be a servant of Christ. I want you to know, brothers, that the gospel I preach is not something that men made up. I did not receive it from any man, nor was I taught it. Rather, I received it by revelation from our Lord Jesus Christ. In Galatians 2:15-21, we who are Jews by birth and not Gentile sinners, know that a man is not justified by observing the law, but by faith in Jesus Christ. So we too have put our faith in Christ Jesus, that we may be justified by faith in Christ and not by observing the law. Because by observing the law, no one will be justified. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Forgiveness, justification, and salvation come only from the saving grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is the only one who can let us enter His eternal kingdom. But to be able to reach the door of His kingdom, we need to follow His way, the Ten Commandments of love. If, while we seek to be justified in Christ, it becomes evident that we ourselves are sinners, does that mean that Christ promotes sin? Absolutely not. If I rebuild what I destroyed, I prove that I am a lawbreaker. For through the law, I died to the law so that I might live for God. The commandments of God showed us that we are a sinner. We put to death the law of sin living in our body, and we now live through the Spirit. And the spiritual law leads us to the gate of God's kingdom. And Jesus Christ, our Father God, will let us enter His kingdom to live with Him forever and ever. Verse 20. I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. This is what it means by having the mind of Christ. Enclose yourself with Christ. The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave Himself for me. If I do not set aside the grace of God, for if righteousness could be gained through the law, Christ died for nothing. The Ten Commandments in itself cannot forgive and save us. We need our Savior, Jesus Christ. The law showed that we are a sinner and needs a saving grace from God, Jesus. Galatians 3:1-29. You foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? Before your very eyes, Jesus Christ was clearly portrayed as crucified. I would like to learn just one thing from you. Did you receive the Spirit by observing the law or by believing what you heard? Are you so foolish? After beginning with the Spirit, are you now trying to attain your goal by human effort? Have you suffered so much for nothing, if it really was for nothing? Does God give you His Spirit and work miracles among you because you observe the law or because you believe what you heard? Consider Abraham. He believed God and it was credited to him as righteousness. Understand then that those who believe that are children of Abraham. The scripture foresaw that God will justify the Gentiles by faith and announce the gospel in advance to Abraham. All nations will be blessed through you. So those who have faith are blessed along with Abraham, the man of faith. All who rely on observing the law are under a curse. For it is written, Cursed is everyone who does not continue to do everything written in the book of the law. Clearly, no one is justified before God by the law, because the righteous will live by faith. The law is not based on faith. On the contrary, the man who does these things will live by them. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone who is hung on a tree. He redeemed us in order that the blessing given to Abraham might come to the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, so that by faith we might receive the promise of the Spirit. Brothers, let me take an example from everyday life. Just as no one can set aside or add to a human covenant that has been duly established, so it is in this case. The promises were spoken to Abraham and to his seed. The scripture does not say and to seeds, meaning many people, but into your seed, meaning one person who is Christ. What I mean is this. The law introduced 430 years later does not set aside the covenant previously established by God and thus do away with the promise. For if the inheritance depends on the law, then it no longer depends on a promise, but God in His grace gave it to Abraham through a promise. What then was the purpose of the law? It was added because of transgressions until the seed to whom the promise referred had come. The law was put into effect through angels by a mediator. A mediator, however, does not represent just one party, but God is one. Is the law therefore opposed to the promises of God? Absolutely not. For if a law had been given that could impart life, then righteousness would certainly have come by the law. But the scripture declares that the whole world is a prisoner of sin, so that what was promised, being given through faith in Jesus Christ, might be given to those who believe. Before this faith came, we were held prisoners by the law, locked up until faith should be revealed. So the law was put in charge to lead us to Christ, that we might be justified by faith. Now that faith has come, we are no longer under the supervision of the law. You are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus. For all of you who are baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. You need to be baptized in Jesus' name. Where? Only on His own given religion that saves the way. There is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus. If you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's seeds and heirs according to the promise.